Alrighty. Now I'm over here.
Okay.
Don't look at that. Okay, so start by saying your first and last name and spelling it.
Valencia Jones, Valencia Jones.
Okay, and tell me, for COVID numbers to be going up again, personally, as a therapist, you know, how does that make you feel?
Well, with the COVID numbers going up, that only means increased isolation. That only means increased, That only means increased isolation. That only means increased trauma. And that only means increased numbers of domestic violence, child abuse, relationship issues, divorce, and domestic violence for me.
And how scary is that, you know, knowing that we were doing so well and trying to get everything under control, and now we're kind of back to square one?
Well, for us in the mental health profession, it is scary because we know these issues are going to resurface, and then that means more people in pain.
And so what are you seeing right now? You know, what are some things that people are dealing with as far as COVID?
As far as COVID, we've seen a lot of financial issues, a lot of relationship issues for being isolated together, a lot of strain on the family as a whole, and violence, increased violence.
And so just me going out and actually speaking to people, some of the things that people are saying, just their feelings, frustration, anger, stress, what does that mean for you as a therapist, and how would you help them cope through these issues?
For someone who's feeling frustrated or isolated or stressed, I would say take this time to self-care. Definitely use self-care, because if you don't take care of yourself, especially in the middle of a pandemic, it's only going to escalate. It's only going to make you feel more isolated, more stressed, more frustrated. So use this time to practice maybe mindfulness to kind of decompose, de-stress, exercise, do hobbies, read, journal, take long soothing baths, whatever your niche is, whatever that thing that interests you, take the time to slow down and indulge yourself in things that are going to help motivate you.
And you spoke about isolation. Some people might be going back into their homes just to protect themselves. What do you do to kind of keep your mind from going into a bad place when you're, you know, you're isolated? Like you said, relationship problems resurface. For some people, they use that time to learn a lot about themselves. What do you do?
Well, if you're feeling isolated, I would definitely use this time to either start a podcast, start a video session online, like start your own YouTube channel, or connect with those resources. Definitely, you can write a book during this time. You can actually journal during this time. This is a lot of things. You can organize your home. You can sit down and make a financial plan. You can make a five-year plan. This is the time that while you're indoors and you're forced to be indoors, utilize that time wisely so that you can actually come out more elevated than when you went in.
And what would you say to those people who are saying, you know, I'm frustrated because I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. I've gotten vaccinated. I'm wearing my mask. And here we are again. People are back in the hospital. We have all this misinformation going on. And I feel like I'm giving up because I've done what I've had to do, and some people aren't, in their opinion. What do you say to those people?
I would say control the things you can control, because there are always factors that we ourselves cannot control. We cannot control other people. That has never changed ever. So the only thing you can do is focus on the fact that, hey, I've done what I'm supposed to do, and I'm going to continue to do the right thing.
And then, can I get you to like turn your body a little bit that way? For me?
This way?
Kind of like where you're looking at me this way.
Okay, no problem.
Perfect. Just so I can see the camera.
Okay.
You're doing great. See, you forgot that camera was even there. You're over here giving me a therapy session and you don't even know it. And what resources are out there, you know, for people who may be at home struggling with some kind of mental illness, depression, those kind of things right now?
I would say contact our local 211 line and tell them what you're missing, what resource you need. And it's a local line that, contact the 211 line, because it's a local hotline that connects you with any and all resources. And especially during COVID, we offer telehealth here at Samaritan Counseling Center, but it's so many organizations who are doing telehealth or virtual sessions. So you don't have to be isolated indoors without mental health.
And so are you seeing an increase in people come in who may have, you know, mental health issues already, and with COVID it's kind of bringing them down?
Oh yeah, definitely. COVID on top of already existing mental health issues has skyrocketed, because if you are already were struggling beforehand and then added all the stress and strain of COVID, it has caused people to be, I guess, exacerbated. And so we see it, a lot of people who said, I've struggled for years with bipolar, depression, but now because I'm isolated, I'm even more, I'm going through major depression or severe depression now.
Wow, so you guys are kind of staying busy as far as
absolutely
that. Wow. Is there like any disparities you'd say as far as mental illness right now, mental issues right now in COVID?
When you say disparities, what do you
mean? Maybe like disparities in race. Are you seeing more African Americans, more white Americans, Asians?
I can honestly say before COVID, it has always been minorities have been less. And during COVID, it has exactly stayed the same. It has not increased at all. Because if you didn't believe in therapy before, you're still less likely, because there's a stigma attached to that.
And lastly, tell me, like I said before, a lot of people don't come and get the services that they need. Tell me about this stigma and how important it is to just ask for help if you need it.
Can I sit back?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, because sitting erect in this chair is horrible.
I'm like, this is a cozy chair.
Okay.
Last question here. Just tell me, you know, how important it is to get help if you need it, because a lot of people may be embarrassed or just don't know that these resources are.
I can also say that mental health is stigmatized, but it needn't be, because everybody gets stressed, frustrated, have arguments, get overwhelmed or exhausted mentally. It doesn't have to always be a severe mental breakdown or something to the extreme. It could be, I need to make a financial plan. It can be, I have trouble with my child right now. It could be, I have relationship issues. We're arguing a lot. It could be something as, I want to set weight loss goals. It does not have to be, I'm having an extreme mental breakdown. It could be you're just stressed and you need to talk to someone to make a plan or practice mindfulness with someone to get the tools that you need to get help. That has nothing to do with mental health. It's just about self-care.
And that 211 line, is that free for people?
Yes, it is. It's absolutely free.
All right. Is there anything else that you would like to add?
Not that I didn't know.
You did great. You did awesome. I'm going to get like this little